Welcome to AquarianRadio.com.
AquarianRadio.com.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio, where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms, because this is the age of peace. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding. No more falsehoods or derisions. Golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
Welcome to the Sacred Matrix, the divine paradigm of universal love. Here, we explore consciousness, learn how to awaken, remember who we are, souls, eternal cosmic beings on a journey through life. At the Sacred Matrix, we interview world-class speakers, authors, teachers, researchers, investigators in the consciousness field. We explore existence, spirituality, and endless magical mysteries that encompass the continuum. Together, we awaken to our full potential, become the loving society we long to be and know we already are. Deep inside, now conscious, awake, and aware, we evolve, learn, grow, become love incarnate in form, and positively affect all of creation, transform all to divine love. Join us. Follow the Sacred Matrix on AquarianRadio.com. Learn more, contribute to our evolution at SacredMatrix.com.
And here are your hosts, Dr. Sasha and Janet Lesson.
Aloha, everybody, and welcome to Aquarian Radio at AquarianRadio.com. This is an episode of The Sacred Matrix, and today's title of today's show is Keshe, 2014, Year of Humanity's Change. M.T. Keshe, a nuclear engineer, Iranian-born, this year, the year of the change, is the year of the change for humanity. So this year, 2014, Dr. Keshe is going to release advanced technologies. He will mass release these technologies to the public. Dr. Lesson wants to begin today. Oh, and I'm your host, Janet Kira Lesson, with co-host Dr. Sasha Lesson. Take it away, Sash.
Aloha. When I researched the worldwide radiation extinction threat from the Fukushima nuclear plant meltdown and the spreading radiation that's already killing newborns in Berkeley, 100,000 of them, as well as the fish, birds, and mammals in the northern Pacific. I was, pretty upset about this Fukushima stuff, and that's what led me to the work of Keshe. A little bit of the background. Fukushima keeps giving more and more radiation to the earth, to the sea, to the air currents, And this is all adding up to the soup of radiation that stays in our ionosphere. And this poisonous soup is getting more and more dangerous to us, according to Lorraine Monet, who's the world's leading radiation expert. Our ionosphere still holds radiation from 2024 BC, when extraterrestrials from the planet Nibiru nuked their rivals on Sinai and in Canaan. So up there in our ionosphere, churning around still, is this radiation from Sinai, and this mixes with the fallout from nuclear destruction the ETs rained on Mohenjo-Daro in the Indus Valley in Pakistan. Added to that, we have radiation from Three Mile Island, from tests in Nevada, the explosion in Chernobyl, Siberia, Bikini, North Korea, all these tests. Then there's depleted uranium shells giving off radiation from Iraq and Kuwait and Afghanistan. There's been lots of nuclear events both on Earth and in space that you don't hear about that also catalyze this huge, growing nuclear monster that hovers up above us. And the radiation adds up and it works itself up into an ever fiercer reaction. Now, every day, Fukushima adds more to this monster. Alfred Weber and others indicate that the very cause of the tsunami that wrecked the Fukushima plant in Japan may have been from the HAARP laser technology that the U.S. and the Soviets have, this HAARP, where they shoot toroidal energies into the ionosphere, which bounces back and causes things like tidal waves. And that Weber says that these hostile ETs are resolved to kill off humanity. And so immersed on this stuff, I said, what are we going to do? Well, then we came across the works of Keshe. Keshe says he can save us. He says he can immediately stop and clean up the fallout from Fukushima. He says he can solve Earth's pollution, economic, and political problems, and give us free transport, unlimited energy, space and time travel as well. And he can do all this with a combination of the gravitation of astronomical bodies and a plasma reactor that he has developed. And, you know, Keshe's claim dovetails with ancient works that's been translated by Sitchin and findings also in Southeast Africa by Tellinger about how energy can be used. It dovetails also with the whistleblowing of Andrew Basiago and Bert Stallings, Swerdlow, Moon, and many others.
Bert Stallings and Andy Basiago is Basiago, and Bert Stallings. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, basically, they report that of about a teleportation system using the same kind of technology that Keshe has. Tesla and Ring have also done a work on this combination of psychokinesis and the tapping of energies of celestial bodies, in Ring's case, the Earth energies. So we're going to now look at Keshe, his idea that 2014 is the year of change for humanity. And the Keshe Foundation was founded by nuclear engineer...
Let me do this, the background, and then we'll switch. So the Keshe Foundation, just to give you a little bit of background, is an independent nonprofit and non-religious organization founded by nuclear engineer M.T. Keshe that aims to develop new scientific knowledge, new technologies, and new solutions to major global problems like famine, water shortage, lack of electrical power supply, climate change, and disease. He does this through the use of specially developed plasma reactors, which will also give mankind the real freedom to travel in deep space. So, do you want to go start on page 1?
Yeah, so with the new understanding of the creation of gravitational forces, like in planetary systems like the Earth, Keshe says that the scientific intellect and knowledge of man has reached a level where we can understand the fundamental principles of creation of this universal motion. All we have to do is tap into it. And Keshe has developed a technology with his plasma reactor that he can apply to travel in space. He's got the plasma reactor, Plus, he has how to tap into the energy of bodies. And are we here, honey?
We're up there. Top
okay.
of page two.
So this new method of using the interaction of gravitational and magnetic fields of the reactor in respect to other celestial objects and similar fields to attain motion and positioning, to create motion, to create energy and food exactly are what we can now do using the Earth and the Sun energy without burning any matter in the universe. And this will be the method, Keshe says, using magnetic fields in a spaceship program.
So in 2014 at the Keshe Foundation, is this the year that advanced technologies are to be mass released to the public so that they can show their power and create conditions that will change through all layers of human society? So we're hoping to affect every human being out there alive at this time. And Keshe says, we shall put an end to hunger and wars through the release of everything in our possession. So he's going to mass release everything he knows, and be it scientific or technical, to every man, woman, and child, be it scientists or world governments around the world in equal measure. So by simultaneously releasing this to everybody, there's going to eliminate this positioning and top dog and control of one faction over the other.
In 2014, Keshe's organization promises to deliver the whole technology. It'll solve everything. With this technology, he says, we're going to put an end to war. We're going to put an end to hunger. We'll make sure that everybody has enough to have enough sustenance and shelter. There won't be any more suffering, he says.
He continues, we give and facilitate the release of our technology to greedy men so that they can produce, this is a lovely concept, he's going to give it to the greedy people so they can produce more than enough gold and more than enough precious materials, all that they could ever wish for, so that they, how he says it, they will shy away even to show any interest in possessing such materials. They're just going to have. They're going to get overwhelmed of so much they won't want it anymore.
Think of Donald Duck's friend Scrooge McDuck, who used to go swimming in a swimming pool full of gold coins. And, that's what Keshe is going to do for the rich people. Oh, you want this stuff here? You can have lots of it. Keshe says that from space we'll be able to get so much precious materials, and there'll be lots and lots of stuff, and we'll just use it for making tools of peace, and that's what they'll be for.
So in 2014 will dawn the beginning of a new era, the point of change for humanity. And this is what we've been, this will be so different from what we've had since the dawn of time, since the time of Adam. This will be mass change. We promise to the world leaders, and this is what we're saying to world leaders, is change your ways and change your nation's ways, or your citizens shall change it for you because of the delivery of these new applications and technologies and their usages. So change is here, like it or not, world leaders, change your way or your citizens are going to make the changes for you.
Keshe says as a result of the technologies he's going to make for us, make available to everybody, no one will take up arms to fight, and no one will be left hungry, and no one will be left homeless because of war on this planet. He tells the industrialists, your factories that have been making weapons are now going to make stuff to help people instead of hurt people.
Right. Now going to deliver homes and food. These same facilities are going to be used for food and homes and providing to people instead of developing weapons of war. But because of the very development of them, they have instigated unwanted wars because of the development of these weapons of war. Okay. And housing. No one will be dependent upon anybody else for the handout of tents, is how he says it. There will be housing for everybody. So no more people living in refugee villages. and depended on someone else to hand out tents. Everybody will have a place to live. That's what I was downloading last night. Everybody has a home in this new paradigm. And he continues and says, we will make delivery of clean water at any point on earth free of charge. This will be a reality because they are going to release these already developed technologies which allow that to happen. The last part's yours, Sash.
Well, that's just, we want you to realize that there is a very, very serious problem of all of us dying, if not just us, our kids, from radiation poisoning, especially right now from the Fukushima ongoing leakage. And we're looking desperately for solutions, and it seems like Keshe may have the solution. We've seen some others that are possible, but there is hope, and this is a time of crisis. On the other hand, this is the Satyuga, the beginning of the dawning of the age of Aquarius, when Quetzalcoatl or Kukulcan said that he was going to be coming back December 21st, 2012, what is it, honey?
Well, honey, you missed the last point. By the end of December, we shall make sure that there'll be space travel on a regular basis from all the nations on this planet, and that they are going to be able to reach the universe collectively and equally. And so he invites everybody to, if you have doubts about our work, be ready to become soldiers of peace and unity before the end of 2014. So that's the end of the message from MT Keshe. So, Keshe. And then you were saying that Quetzalcoatl, the end of the Mayan calendar, last 12/21/12, was actually about the return of Quetzalcoatl, who is Ningxia, who is Thoth.
That's right. And the Billy Meyer materials and several other things basically say that the good Pleiadians are coming back to get us out of this exploitation system where greed and hierarchy runs everything, and have this planet respect the consciousnesses that are here, feminine consciousness as well as men, and to stop polluting the environment out of greed.
Well, this seems, you know, I've been waiting for this all my life. Like you said, we've been waiting for this since the beginning of time, since Adam's time, for a time of peace and prosperity where everybody gets their needs met. And so what Keshe is saying is that he has, and I invite you to, you know, don't just take our word for it. Go on to the internet and Google MT, it's spelled K-E-S-H-E. Keshe.
Well, you've got some of his articles and YouTubes on our sites, don't
right,
you?
And we have them on our we've created a page, a couple of pages for Keshe on AquarianRadio.com, and we are investigating this information because, you know, for me, this is kind of fulfilling an internal excitement that's been generating within me that there is something happening, and I'm a channel. I channel. I know people go, oh, channeling. But anyway, I channel. And I get information. I get downloads. And one of my guests on, we have a show on Revolution Radio called The Sacred Matrix, as well as our Aquarian Radio Network. And somebody on there was, you know, talking about channels. And they said, well, you know, a lot of the channel information has brought incredible advances in technology here. And people don't know how to explain it when someone says, well, how did you come up with that invention or that song or whatever it was. And they just said, well, I you know, I was just sitting there and all of a sudden it came to me. It downloaded. So where does it come from? So basically everything in the universe is there and available for someone to tap into it. And that's why you will simultaneously see many inventions simultaneously coming to people at the same time. Because it's up there in the morphogenic field. It's up there in the grid. It's up there in the cosmos for people to access. So I'm accessing this information. And what's been exciting for me is that despite all this bad news and the negativities, I've been excited that something good and wonderful and marvelous is about to happen. So this reminds me of when the Berlin Wall came down. And to give you a little history, when I was a child, I was born in 1954, and my parents were both involved. They lived through the World War II. And my dad suffered from PTSD, which is post-traumatic stress disorder, because he was one of the first in and the last out in World War II. He was drafted, and he was over in Italy the entire time, living out in the field. He used to tell me how horrendous it was. They were just out in the field for like 4 years, and so he was traumatized when he got home. He was shell-shocked, and he was lucky to survive because very few of his other troops, his mates, survived. And then my mother was traumatized her dad died when she was 10 years old. She was born in 1922. So she went through the Depression with her mom and her grandma. And these were three women trying to get through those times. And there, back in those days, there weren't jobs for women. So she told me horrendous stories of how they were starving all the time. So we went through, I was born with this attitude. And we, in the 60s, started to happen. It was so exciting. The 60s was an era of hope. And yet at the same time, we went from World War II to the Korean War to the Cold War with Russia. I remember Nikita Khrushchev. Remember Nikita Khrushchev pounding, taking his shoe off and pounding on the desk at the United Nations. And what did he say? I will conquer you. I will take over.
I will bury you.
I will bury you. That's right. I knew you were old enough to remember that. And then the 60s happened, and it was so exciting with all the baby boomers and this new generation of people wanting to change the planet. And there was the Vietnam War. And so so here we went through, after the Vietnam War, there was a relative sense of peace, but there's always something. And there was this Berlin Wall that came up after World War II, and it was erected by the communists to keep people, behind this wall, literally. And so we would hear stories of people escaping and coming to the free world. So there was the world that was dark and the free world. So, and I don't remember what year that was, but I remember the day the Berlin Wall came down, because everybody was shocked, because we thought it was going to go on forever, because that was the way the world was. And we were all kind of resigned to it. And then all of a sudden, the Berlin Wall was down in a day. And everybody was free and liberated. So this is what the Keshe announcement, how it feels to me, what it resonates is that something exciting like this will happen. And it may not be Mr. Keshe or Dr. Keshe. And it may not be his technologies, but it's there. It's in the grid. These resolutions for our problems have been there all along. Do you have something to say, honey? All right, so that's today's episode. Thank you very much for coming today. Say aloha.
Aloha.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thanks for joining us today on Aquarian Radio. We broadcast daily, and our schedule is on aquarianradio.com. Listen live by calling 646-649-0893, or you can listen live by calling 646-649-0893, or listen to our archives on aquarianradio.com. Join us again soon, and do tell your friends, the age of Aquarius and the paradigm of peace is now.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio, where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms, because this is the age of peace. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, no more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
And this has been another episode here at AquarianRadio.com.
AquarianRadio.com.
Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abound.